Hello everybody, my name is Blue from the Blue Chicken Studios crew, and you are watching my third and final episode of How to Make a Top-Down Shooter. In the last two episodes, I showed you how to make the player always look at the mouse by rotating to the mouse's position and move around. We also added in the last episode the shooting mechanics. When we left click, our player then shoots bullets. In this episode, we will be covering enemy AI, the enemy's death, and the player's health. Insert a new object, select sprite, and call it enemy. I'll be making mine a deep red. Set the size to 100 by 50 pixels. Make sure that your enemy is facing your player. Add a new behavior to your enemy and select bullet. Once this has been done, go back to your event sheet, add a new event, select enemy, select every tick, enemy, set angle towards position of player.x and player.y. So now our enemy will be now chasing our player, but he is very fast and we want to set his speed a bit lower. Set the speed to 95 pixels per second. Now when you run the layout, your enemy will now move towards where your player is, thus making it seem like it is enemy AI. But when we shoot him, nothing happens. What we want to do is go to our event sheet, add an event, select bullet, and on collision with another object, and select enemy. Now when our bullet collides with our enemy, we want our enemy to be destroyed. Before we test the layout, insert a new object, particles. Make it any color you want. I'll be making mine a few red dots. Set the spray cone to 360 degrees. This way it will make a big explosion. Set the size to 20 by 20. Make it a one shot. And we now need to add another action for our enemy to spawn another object and select particles. Drag it above your destroying and now run the layout. When we shoot our enemy, he will now spawn those particles. Awesome! I think we've actually done very good. Now, add another event and select system. And scroll down to the bottom and select every X second. I'll be setting mine to every 3 seconds. So every 3 seconds, we want our system to create a new object at random. At the X, we want to type 12 to 800. And for the Y, random. And we want to type in 30 to 854. Select your enemy. So now, every 3 seconds, a new enemy will spawn somewhere. And presto, we have now got a very basic top-down shooter. But now we want to add a new group to organize all of our program. Call this enemies. Drag all of your code underneath. You can now minimize your groups. Add a new object and select text. Insert this into your project and select any color. I will keep mine at black. You can also set the size to anything you want. Make sure if you've got a bigger size text that you resize the little box. Now, go back into your event sheet, insert a global variable and call this PH for player health. Set the value to 100. As you can see, we've now got a green bar here, and that is our global number. Add a new event, select system, every tick. Add an action for our text to set the text to inside these two little inverted speech commas type help. Also type the AND symbol, which can be done with SHIFT and then the 7 key. And then type PH, which will reference to our global number. Also, we now need to add that when our enemy collides with our player, it then minuses 10 health. So enemy, on collision with another object, select player. Add an action for the system to subtract from our player health a value of 10. Select add another event and compare our variable. If player health is equal to 0, player destroy. Now add a new group and call this health. Drag all of your code underneath this group, and you have now effectively made a top-down shooter. Let's have a quick test play and see how long we can survive. Run the layout, and presto, we now have a functioning top-down shooter. I hope you guys have enjoyed this tutorial series. I certainly have had a lot of fun making it. I really hope that all of your top-down shooters are fantastic and that you had a great time making them. Make sure that you smash that big, fat, red subscribe button, and I really hope you have a constructive day.